everyone. Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. We're going to be doing another partial derivatives problem today. This one is the function r of st equals 5t squared over s. And the first thing that we're going to want to do with this problem is, of course, find the partial derivatives with respect to both s and t. So we have the partial derivative of r with respect to s and the partial derivative of r with respect to t. So we're going to start with the partial derivative of r with respect to s, and the first thing that we'll do is convert the problem from a fraction to a non-fraction by moving the s in the denominator to the top. And the way that we're going to do that is by changing the sign on the exponent with the following formula here. So this formula, and it's super useful in calculus, we use it all the time, tells us that when we have something in the denominator of a fraction here, and it's raised to the exponent n, that we can change the sign on the exponent from a positive, see this is a positive n here, to a negative n, and move that whole thing to the numerator. We could also then move it back to the denominator by changing the sign on the exponent from a negative back to a positive, but it lets us flip-flop it back and forth just by changing the sign. So that's what we're going to go ahead and do with this problem. We have an s in the denominator. It's raised to the first power. That one exponent is implied. So when we move it to the numerator, instead of s to the positive 1 in the denominator, we'll have s to the negative 1 in the numerator. So we go ahead and convert the fraction to 5t squared times s to the negative 1. So now that we've converted it, it's going to make it a lot easier to take the partial derivative with respect to s. So remember that when we take the partial derivative with respect to s, we're going to be treating s as the variable and t as the constant. So the way that I like to think about it is I like to plug in a number for t. Like if we were to say that t is equal to 3, right? We're treating t as a constant, so we can put a number, a constant number, like 3, in its place. So if you imagine, here in this problem, that t is equal to 3, right? We'd have 3 squared, which would be 9. 9 times 5, which would be 45. And you'd have 45 s to the negative 1. I know this is a little abstract, but what I'm hoping that you can see is that that t squared would get absorbed into the coefficient, right? It would stick with that, with the 5 here coefficient. That would become a 45 s to the negative 1. So that t squared, when we treat it as a constant, is going to be part of the coefficient on this s to the negative 1 term. And then, of course, we'll treat s to the negative 1 as the variable. So imagine that t is part of the coefficient, and we'll just take the derivative of s as we normally would with a variable x, which is that we will multiply the negative 1 in the exponent here on the s by the coefficient 5t squared, and then we'll subtract 1 from the exponent. So we have this negative 1 here in front, and then we say negative 1 minus 1 in the exponent, which is what we do with any basic derivative. So then it's just a matter of simplification. So we have a negative 5 out in front here because we have that negative 1 times 5. The t squared stays, and then we have s to the negative 2 from the negative 1 minus 1. And then all we want to do to simplify this, you never want to finish a problem with a negative exponent if you can avoid it. So we're going to go ahead and move that s term to the denominator again using the same formula from before. We've got a negative exponent in the numerator. When we move it to the denominator, that's going to go from a negative to a positive. So we'll end up with negative 5t squared over the quantity s squared. Now let's go ahead and take the partial derivative of r with respect to t. Again, we're going to start out with 5t squared times s to the negative 1. We move that s to the top, and we change the sign on the exponent from a positive to a negative. And then to find the partial derivative with respect to t, we'll be treating s as the constant term and t as the variable. So if you imagine that s is part of the coefficient with the 5, we're not going to touch it. It's a constant. So that s to the negative 1 is going to stay the same. You can just leave it there. We're going to instead take the derivative of the variable t. So since we have t squared here, we're going to multiply that 2 out in front, and we have the 2 here multiplied by the coefficient. And then in the exponent on the t, we say 2 minus 1 as if we were taking the derivative normally. And then again, it's just a matter of simplification. We end up with 10t times s to the negative 1. And then to finish the problem, we move s to the denominator, changing the negative 1 exponent to a positive 1, and we end up with 10t over s. And those end up being our final answers for the partial derivative of r with respect to s and the partial derivative of r with respect to t. So I hope that helped, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!